All right, so we have the very talented Kensington Cross.
Kensington Cross.
Kensington, here. I apologize. Kensington Cross.
No, it's fine, man. No worries.
So speaking
new
of
artists, that's what happened.
That's new artist and very talented. So speaking of your name, what does your name mean and what does it represent?
Well, basically, it's a spin on my last name, which is East Indian descent. My grandfather's from Indian, so it's just true to me. I mean, I thought it sounded cool, so we just kicking around with it.
Yes. Sounds very cool. Okay, so do you write your own music?
Yeah, I write everything. I think that's really important. It's really important for an artist to be connected to his or her art, you know, and be well defined as an artist. I think that's really important because in this climate, it's a part in between, you know. But I will say that I wanted my music to be my truth, and I wanted it to be honest. So, you know, I'm very hands-on, not just writing, but with creating the concept of music videos, styling, all of it.
Okay.
It's all. I'm passionate about it.
And speaking of style, who gives you your inspiration? Who inspires you to do what you do?
Style-wise
and music-wise.
Well, pretty much, my grandfather owned a record shop, shut it down, and pretty much had an extensive catalog of music. So he moved all that. He closed the record shop down and he dedicated to the garage. I wasn't supposed to be back there, but, you know, as bad kids, you know, we do what we're supposed to do. So I went back, I started going back to the garage, and I learned how to work a record player. And that's where I found records like, you know, Rick James, Cold Blooded, Prince, and far before my time, but it was something about the music because it had musical transitions and progressions, and it felt honest, and it still would have pop elements to it, like Prince. Was very pop, but also was soulful. It wasn't naked. So because that was at my disposal, and I can see it. I've been influenced by artists like Prince, David Bowie, Depeche Mode, as well as Annie Lennox. A lot of 80s. I feel like in the 80s, what happened with the 80s was we're coming out of the 70s, where the 70s was about musicianship. Or what have you, and then we moved into the 80s where we got a lot more experimental, which, you know, but we still have the knowledge of musicianship. So, yeah, I mean, I'm excited about it.
Okay.
The music is really, really cool, and, you know, I produce, write, everything. I mean, you know, I do a lot of collabing on production just because I like to get a record as a musician. And a lot of times when I'm creating the records, it's almost like a jam session. We're building from the ground up. It's going in, so.
Okay.
Yeah.
And speaking of collaborations, what artists would you like to work with in the future and why?
Ooh, Sade. I would love a battle with Sade, man. Because there's nobody like her. That voice is breathtaking.
Very true.
Yeah.
All right. Well, my two favorite songs are Horses and Arabian Paradise.
Thank you.
You're welcome. What are your inspirations behind those songs? Like, what made you write those songs, or what gave you the idea to come up with such a, you know, a different style? And
My thing is, for one, I set out creating the EP and the album. I set out to do something with music that hadn't been done in a long time. If you listen to Purple Rain and Thriller, those artists weren't genre specific. They just did what they felt. You know what I'm saying? They were musicians that just connected to the music. And with this body of work, I wanted to make something that started pop, you know, was in this weird, kooky, indie pop place. And, you know, for Arabian Paradise release, I was influenced by David Bowie and also some East Indian stuff. And basically, you know, I wanted to, you know, start popping, and we just kind of like, funny enough, like I said, it's like jam sessions when we create records. Start one way, and you know, we add an instrument here, and we'll add some drums, and we'll get some hi-hats in there, and it got a reaction feel. We just, you know, I wanted it to have layers. And funny enough, I think one of the records that described me as a person the most is probably Arabian Paradise, because it's so versatile, you know? And then as for Horses, it just feels good.
That record just feels good. I'm really excited about that. I love it. The time I'm performing, it's so fun. And it's becoming a fan favorite.
Yeah, it's definitely one of my favorites. Can you tell the fans, the people, how they can get in contact with you, or how they can deal, you know, reach out to you? Or
Kessington Cross, KessingTon, Cross with a K. Again, that's KessingTon, Cross with a K. You can check me on Instagram, Twitter, both same names. Obviously, you know about the at sign. Also, check out the music video from Evo as well as YouTube. And the song Give Me Your Love, the single, you can get that on iTunes as well. So, yeah.